Greetings, I'm Rob Chapman, and welcome to Traditional versus Traditional. Two guitars, kind of the same, kind of different, both from Chapman. I am monumentally biased, and in this battle of the shred, only one guitar can win, and you will decide in the commentary section below. So please powerhouse that full of words, and let's see who wins. Pro-traditional or traditional standard? You may notice these guitars are both completely naked, because I thought it would only be fair to completely restring both of them with great big packets of brand new, shiny, lovely Paradigms from fantastic Ernie Ball. If you're interested, it's the Paradigm 10 to 52 set, which is what I normally use, so that they both have all of that brand new strung and stretched in top end. So let me just string these for you. Okay, all strung. One of the unsung heroes of amazing locking tuners like these hip shots we have on this Chapman Pro is that it's super quick to string the guitar. I mean, it's taken me 45 minutes to string, tune, and actually intonate the standard model, because it's been with a friend who's been gigging it and he intonated it for his gauge of strings. But I reckon about 45 minutes, this Pro model probably took me 10, 12 minutes to string, tune the whole thing. It's just so quick. You just put it through, lock it off, chop it, and then just tune it. There's no winding and all that kind of gubbins. So I love hip shot tuners. Anyway, let's start with the Pro. So this is the ML3 Pro Traditional. It has an Alder top, solid Alder, Alder body. It's carved, as you can probably see. It is a beautiful carve. It comes with a couple of hot telly pickups from Seymour Duncan. These are USA ones. And what that means is these are waxed to remove like microphonic squeaks and unwanted noise, that kind of thing. And these magnet poles are hand ground. I don't know whether the hand grinding makes them, you know, massively better than not hand grounding, but that's something they do on these really nice pickups. The bridge pickup is about 16 ohms. It's about twice as powerful, twice as much resistance as this neck pickup. So you hear a big difference, not necessarily in volume, but you hear a difference in how clean it is. This is built to slay dragons, and this is built to lullaby princesses. I don't know where that came from. So it has a baked maple neck, as you can see, stainless steel frets. It has lume inlays. These are super bright lume inlays. When I used to play circuit touring with Dorje, my amazing tech Pablo would use a torch and like charge up the lumen laser and we'd go on. And that was really, really cool. This is one of the models from a couple of years ago. We've reissued this in different colors, but it's essentially the same guitar. So this came in this beautiful argent metallic silver color, or it came in a black and a bunch of others, but there's a whole lot of new colors now. So go and check out the new colors of Chapman's ML3 Pro Traditional. You can find this in stores for like about a grand, you know. So shop around. It's a great guitar. I have personally recorded many songs with actually this guitar, but also this kind of guitar. And I sort of kicked this off at Chapman really with a model called the ML3 RC. I don't know if any of you have been following me long enough to remember the golden days of the ML3 RC, which was my dream. I wanted a carved top T-type, and we made it sort of a really simplistic version, and I love that guitar. Anyway, the difference really is that this is a bolt-on. Gives you a very particular kind of sound, makes repairs much easier, comes with strap locks. I mean, we may as well include a little bell and a little whistle in the box, because to be quite honest with you, everything you'd ever need is on this guitar. I should also point out, this actual guitar has been gigged a lot, and not just by me. I have gigged it, and my friend Luke has gigged it a lot, which is why these bridges are now taking on some age. It's being gradually hand-relicked. We live in Malta. It's very hot and sweaty here, and we've toured it through the summer, so it's taken a little bit of wear, a couple of little dings from playing on stages and things, and like I said, a little bit of, you know, grit on the brass saddles. Brass saddles sound great, and in my opinion, they give a little tiny bit of high-end sheen to open strings, which is why I like a brass nut as well. This isn't brass, but if it wasn't for the fact that I kind of need to keep them as stock as possible, I'd be swapping it out for a brass nut, and I'd scallop it as well. And I like that because when I hybrid pick for my sort of southern stuff, I like to have high-end sheen on the open strings. Yngwie agrees with me. Anyway, this is how this guitar sounds. I'm using the Ritchie Kotzen Cornford 50 watt combo. Position. So you can hear, it's barking at you with its bridge position pickup. And you can really set this up to kind of give you the two-channel vibe on an amplifier. What I would do is wind the neck real low in the body, if possible. In fact, you know what? I'm just gonna do it and then show you literally what it is that I'm talking about, because I don't do enough of these practical hints and tips and hacks and things, and I probably should do because I'm old, I've been playing a long time, and I think some of the younger viewers who maybe haven't even had the opportunity to play live would like to know some of these tricks from the road. So look, I've wound the neck pickup super low, so the output's going to be really, really low now, and what I've got now is this kind of, hear that? Really low. And if I flick it to the bridge, and why that's good is because if I want my amplifier to have a crunch sound and then I'm smacking on the boost to give me a soaring lead, it will now do that. So here is, like a soft crunch for rhythm playing. But when I pull it back into the lead position, now that's all just with the guitar, but I've got a boost on this amplifier. It could be, you know, any kind of gain pedal, but with the boost, it's now going to go. Thank you. say, you see, I've now set up three kinds of tonality with one guitar and just a stomp box. In this case, it's the boost circuit of the amplifier. I really like that. That's what I like about Gibson Les Pauls, is with the number of volume controls you've got on the three-way, you can get, you can set it up to have a couple of the different sounds. But you can really do it with any guitar if you just smack in the neck pickup. Anyway, this is ML3 Pro Traditional. Let's take a look at what the standard range offers. I just love this guitar. I have a real soft spot for sort of the more affordable products. Not to say I don't love the high-end stuff. I absolutely do. But there's something about affordable workhorse guitars that just gets me excited about things I can do to them. That sounds a bit pervy, but you know what I'm saying. Anyway, differences. Maple neck, it's not torrified, it's not baked, but we stained it to make it look as if it could be baked. it doesn't have locking tuners. It has good old-fashioned standard tuners. Did you know that you can tension the tuners with a screwdriver at the end of the tuner? I'm probably telling you something that you already know, and I'm sorry if that's the case. But if you didn't know, you can tension them. You can make them super rock hard solid, in effect kind of giving you a locked tuner. Now, I'm not suggesting that you tighten these so much that you can't turn them, but just make sure they're not super loose. If you touch it with one finger, it shouldn't go anywhere. Do you know what I mean? It should just stay where it is. And provided you are, you know, experienced enough in tying the end of a string, once you've got these rigid, it should stay in tune really well. No loom inlays, just fret markers and side dots, that kind of thing. Then, nice swamp ash top. I believe it's a mahogany body, but you know what? I'm just going to check, because I honestly cannot remember. Well, I was absolutely correct. It's just a mahogany body. I believe it is Sapele, but I'm not actually sure what genus of mahogany this is. It's quite lightweight, but not too lightweight that you don't feel like you've got a quality guitar in your hands. Biggest difference really is this. So this is Chapman's own Angry Mule P90, as voiced by me and some other incredible people at Chapman. And this is just Chapman's own single coil offering. Alnico pickups. This is a beautiful sounding, crunchy thing. And then this is lovely and silky and sweet and everything. And really, it's kind of giving you, you know, the best of both worlds. Tone volume, three-way. Again, this guitar has been gigged extensively over here and demoed and used a lot. So it's picking up a little bit of wear, and there's a little bit of scratchiness in here. I need to give it some cleaning fluid. I haven't been nice to it enough. But this is how the affordable offering sounds. And by the way, please bear in mind, this is like roughly a grand. This is half the price. Anyway. Beautiful. Let me again do a similar thing with this that I did with that Pro. Let me just... Okay, I've just adjusted the pickup so it's louder, higher, got more output than the Angry Mule. And let's take a listen to how this can be set up. We'll be right back. agree, that's absolutely astounding. And it really handles gain well. So here's my boost circuit. Wins, in your opinion? I'm interested because, you know, we are the listening guitar company. If you want to tell us things, we will definitely listen to what you say. We're collaborative. We love having your opinion on board. Is it the absolutely stunning but affordable Chapman ML3 Standard Traditional, or is it the equally stunning, slightly up-specced ML3 Traditional Pro. Pro Traditional. Only you can decide. Let me know. Take it easy. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe, smash the bell, hammer a like, and leave a comment in the comment section below. Take it easy.